हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आर यू गेटिंग माय स्क्रीन एंड माय वॉइस?
यस सर,
यस सर,
ओके। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट बाइनरी अरिथमेटिक एंड अदर्स, लिटिल बिट एडिशन, सबट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लेक्सर, ऑल द बाइनरी एंड ऑक्टल सिस्टम एंड हेक्साडेसिमल सिस्टम। देन वी विल गो टू द कॉम्प्लीमेंट, वंस कॉम्प्लीमेंट, टूज कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स, एंड्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स एंड सो ऑन। So first we'll discuss the binary addition. Binary addition, we have to add two binary numbers, like two decimal number. We have a two decimal number, like you can take any decimal number, 7 and 25. So what will be the addition? It will be 275. If you add two decimal number. One decimal number, two decimal number, you add this one. How you are doing? How you are writing this number in this way? 5 × 10^2 plus 4 × 10^1 plus 7 × 10^0. This one. And you have to add 5 × 10^0 plus 2 × 10^1. So you have to add this. Here decimal number. So we have a digit from 0 to 9. If you go beyond this 9, then it will generate a carry. Like if you add two numbers, like if you say 4 + 5 = 9, this is the sum and carry is 0. But if you add 5 + 6, then what will be the sum? Will be 11, means sum will be 1 and carry will be 1, and carry will shift to next digit, because it will be 11. So we can write 10 in it will be 1 × 10^1 plus 1 × 10^0. This one will go to the will shift to the left hand side, because left hand side it is the this is the for 10^1 row column. It is the column it is column this, and it is the zero. So if you add 5 × 7, so it will be 12. So sum will be 2 and carry will come to left side. So it will be carry. So now it will be, what will be? 4 × 6 and 1 = 7. There is no carry. So carry will be 0. So it will be 5. This is your decimal addition. Now come to the same way to the binary addition. Binary addition, what if you add 0 + 0, if you sum and carry, if you add 0 + 0, sum will be 0, carry will be 0. 0 + 1, sum equal 1, carry will be 0. 1 + 0, sum is 1, carry is 0. Then 1 + 1, it will be 2. So sum will be 0, carry will be 1, because 1 + 2, but in the case of binary you have only two digits, 0 and 1. Beyond the 1, if you go more than 1, so it will go to the next session, go to the left hand side, because in case of binary you can see your 2 and 1, the coefficient a0 2^0 plus a1 2^1 plus and so on. So if you go more than 1, it will go to the this side. This is the your binary addition. If you add 1 1, this is the sum 1, carry will be 0. 0 1, sum is 1, carry will be 0. 1 0, sum is 1, carry 0. And most important, this way, this is the sum 0, carry 1. And if you go if you take the 2 digit, 2 binary digit, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 0, 1. So what will be? 0 plus 1, sum is equal to 1, carry 0, so it will be 0. So 0, 1, 0, then sum is 1, carry 0, then 1, 1. Means sum will be 0, carry is 1. So what is the it is 0, 1, 0 means 4 to this was 6 and this is the 5. If you add 6 plus 5 equal to 11. Now you can see this is the 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3. So this is the 8 plus 0 plus 4 plus 1. So it will be 11. So in this way you can add. So you can add any number in binary.
There
number.
Will be 2, sir.
Which one?
The 4 1.
Okay, yeah, definitely it will be 2. Sorry, it will be 2. Sure. Thank you. It will be 2. So it will be 11. In this way, you can add the binary number. It is just the same logic as a decimal number. So if you add the octal number and hexadecimal number, this concept will be more clear. So your homework, you can take this to do some few work. Like in one, you can do this one, 10011, then 1 1 1 1 1 0. This type of you can do. So okay, let's do this one. This will be the 10. It will be 1. Here will be, here will be 0. So here will be 0. Then 1 1, sum is 0. Here will be 1. Then 1 1, sum 0, carry will be 1, then 1, 1, sum 0, carry is 1. Now, 1, 1, 1, it will be 3. What will be 3? Then, if you 1, 1, 1, then your sum is equal to 1 and carry also is equal to 1. Because it's 3, so we can write this one. So, we can, this is your sum, this is the carry. So, in this case, this is the sum, this is your carry will be forward, then it will be again sum 1, carry will be 1. So let's see what happened. This is your 1 binary number. So what is the value of binary number? This is the 1 plus 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. 2 plus 16 plus 32. And this number is 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16 plus 32. If we add, you can get this number. You can if you do the just decimal addition, you can get this number. So we'll come the subtraction after this. By the okay, octal addition. So let's finish first the addition. So we will do the octal addition. Octal number, you can see the two number A plus B. A plus B with two numbers, so you can see A1 plus A0, B1. If you take A plus B, you can write in this way. A1, A0, B1, B0. So, in octal system, we have a digit from 0 to n minus 1. octal system base is 8, so it will be 0 to 7. If you add number, if after addition, if sum is more than 7, then it generate a carry. If you add this one and a0 plus b0 is equal to c0, if c0 less than or is equal to 7, then sum is equal to c0 and carry is equal to 0. And if this c0 greater than 7, then it generate some carry. It will generate a carry, and carry will be forward to the next left hand side. So let's do two example. So if it is greater than 7, then how to write this one? C0. If greater than 0, then we can write it in terms of C0 is equal to C into A plus sum. Okay, let's say do some example, it will be more clear. 2, 4, 3 and add 1, 2, 1, 2. Then if you add 3 plus 2 is equal to 5, 4 plus 1 is equal to 5, 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. So no digit, sum of two digit is always in this case less than or equal to 7. So it is the answer, and no summation of two digits generate carry. But if you take this number 5, 3, 7 and 2, 4, 3, then what will be this one? 7 and 3, it will 10. So we have a 10 means 8 minus 2. So sum will be 2, carry will be this one. In 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. 10, so we can write 1, 2 in case of octal system. So 2 will become here, 1 will be go here. So now if you add 4, 6, 10 and 11, so it will be 3, carry will become here. Then 5 to 7 on 8 will be 0, 1. So this is one by octal number, and this is one octal number. If you this two octal number, it's the another octal number. Like 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. So it is more than a 7. That's why it is how much it will be? Sum will be 2 and carry will be forward here. So next step is 6 plus 4, 10 plus 1. So it is more than 8. So it will be 3 and carry will be here. So here it will be 5, 2, 7, 1, 8. 8 will be 0 plus 1. This is your octal addition. Because 10 is always greater than your 7, greater than 7, how much 7? 10 is equal to 10 is equal to 8 plus 2 is equal to 10. That's why we can write here instead of 10 you write 2 and one carry will come here. Let's see the hexadecimal addition. Hexadecimal addition, we have a in a digit from 0 to 9, then A, B, C, D, E, F. 9 A equal to 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Take two hexadecimal number, 1, 5, 6, 8, 9, 1 hexadecimal number, another 5, 4, 7, 4. If you 2 add to the hexadecimal number, then 9 plus 4, what will be the 9 plus 4 will be your 13. So 13 means your D. 13 equal to your D. So sum is your 13 and carry will be your 0. Now 8 plus 7 will be 15. 15 will be F. The sum is F, carry will be 0 because it is yet 15, not 16. More than 15, if it is more than 15, then it will generate a 1 carry. Now 6 plus 4 plus 0 is equal to your 10. 10 means your A. Then 5 and 5 equal 10, 10 is equal to A. And take another example, A, D, D, and you are adding D, A, A. So what will be? Okay, you take it. A, D, D, and if you add D, A, D. So your 0 to 9, then 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 9, A, D, 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 E, and F. D means your 13. 13 plus 13 is equal to 26. 13 plus 13 is equal to 26. So, it will generate a carry and one sum. Your 16 means in case of 15, your F. In case of 16, how you are writing 16 is equal to, in case of 16, in case in hexadecimal we are writing 1 1, one zero. So it will carry will be 1 and sum will be 0. So 26 we can write 16 plus 10 means 1, it will thus carry and sum is equal to A. So it will be A. A here and your carry will be go here. Now D is equal to your 13, A is equal to 10. 13 plus 10, D is equal to your 13, A is equal to 10 plus 1. So it will be 25. 25 means 16 plus.
Only it will be 24.
24, no? Okay. It will be 24. Then 16 plus 8. 24 equals 16 plus 8. So again, it will generate one carry and it will be give a 8. Again, D and D plus A plus 1. So 24. So it will be 8 and 1. So if you add to a hexadecimal number, A D D plus D A D, here every time generate a carry. So your result will be this one. If you convert just it is a decimal number, you convert this decimal number and add to decimal number, definitely you will got this number. This is your addition. Means already we have discussed the addition decimal, then we export the logic from decimal to binary. Then we discuss about the octal and hexadecimal addition. Now we have to discuss about the subtraction. Let's do about the subtraction, how to subtract two number in case of decimal, then we'll go to the binary number system. So in case of, like, you can say,
sir, your screen sharing has been stopped.
Already stopped. Okay. Okay, I don't know why it is already stopped. Okay, I have to log out and again log in. Maybe then it will be.
Yes, sir.
Because I am not getting any sharing option. Okay, I am going log out, then again log in within 1 minute.
Okay, sir. सर बाइनरी का सब्सट्रैक्शन बढ़ाने वाले थे ना इसके बाद.
हाँ
So now, are you getting this screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Like, if you want to subtract in case of decimal, let two number minus 22, so it will be 5 and it will be 0. Okay. But if you subtract here 32 and you have to subtract 17. So you cannot, it is a something bigger than 7 is larger than 2. So you have to what you have to take, you have to borrow 1 from here. If you borrow 1 from 3 to 2, the value will be 12. If you take it, borrow 1 from here, so it will be 2 plus 10 to the power 1, so it will be 12. And right now it will be 2. If you give the borrow from here to here, so its value will be reduced to 2 and its value will change to 12. Now you can subtract. So it will be 5. And here it is 1 1. In this way we can subtract. if it is a if this number 7, right, now 7 is greater than 2, so subtract this one, you have to take a borrow from left side, and if you take the borrow from left side to here, it's it will increase to plus 10 to the power 1, because the voltage of this side is 1, voltage this side is 0. Now value is not 2, it is value is 12. Similarly, you can think any number of decimal number. And same thing we will do in case of binary subtraction. If you take 2 digits, one digit, and 1 digit, 1 0 1 1 0. So what will be it? If you subtract, it will be 1, this will be 0, here 0, so you cannot subtract, you have to take borrow from here to here. So now its value is the 2, so it is 1, so if you subtract from 2 from 1, it will be 1, and as it's going to in this direction, it will be 0, so 0 minus 0 will be 0, 0 to 1, 1 will be, it will be 0. Now see, what is the value? It will be 1100. What is the 1100 means? It will be 1 plus 2 plus 8 plus 60. So what the value? It will be 27. And what is the value here? It will be 0 plus 2 plus 4 plus 60, so it will be 22. So 27 minus 22 is equal to 27 minus 22 is equal to 5. Now its value, what's its value? It's equal to 1 0, it will be 4 4, it will be 5. So if you subtract binary from this number to this number, you will get this one, and it is your verification. Just like you convert this binary number to decimal number and subtract 22 from 27, and it will be 5. And similarly, it is the verification. So take another example, 1 1 1 0, and you have to subtract 1 1 1. So it is a 0, you cannot subtract, so you have to take a borrow from here to here. Now it is value is 2, and its value is going to be 0. So now it will be 1. Now it is 1, and now it is the 0, and it is a 1. Again, you have a problem. You have to take a borrow from here to here. Yeah, if you take a borrow from here to here, this value will be 0, and it is a 2. So 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 1, and here is equal to 0, here is equal to 1. Again, you have a problem, that's why you have to take the borrow from here to here. So now it is that 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. After giving the borrow from here, it will be the 0. So our subtraction was 1 1 1 0 minus 1 1 1, and we will receive 0 1 1 1. You can take any 0 there, it is not problem. Okay. So let's see the verification. What is the value of this number? This is 8 plus 4 plus 2. 8 plus 4 plus 2 means 14. And here is equal to 4 plus 2 plus 1 means 7. If you subtract, this will be 7. And 1 plus 1 plus 1 is also 7. In this way, we can subtract some binary numbers, and similar way from to the octal subtraction. Octal subtraction. Take your octal number as 7, 4, 3, and you subtract 5, 6, 4. You subtract. It is a 4. It is 3. That's why you have to take a borrow one number from here to here. If you take the borrow, so it's a 4 value will change to 3, and what will be this value? This will be 3 plus 8, because here is a here it will 8 to the power 0, 8 to the power 1. So 3 plus 8 is equal to 11. So now if you subtract 11 minus 4, it will be 7. Now it is a 3 and it will 6. Again, you cannot subtract, so you have to take a borrow here. If you take the borrow, then it will be 8 plus 3, again 11. 11 minus 6, 11 minus 6, it will be 5. And here it will be, after giving a borrow, one borrow from 7 to 4, it will be 6, it will be 1. So this is your answer. You are subtracting 5, 6, 4 from 7, 4, 3. Similarly, you take another example. 6, 2, 4, and you are subtracting 2, 6, 5. So, it is 5, it is 4. So, we have to take borrow 1 here. So, after taking borrow, this value will be 12. 5 minus 12 equal to 7, and it's equal to 1. After giving a borrow, it is 1. So 8, again you have to take borrow from here. 8 plus 1 equal to 9. 9 minus 6 is equal to 3. So it is a 5. So 2 minus 3 equal to 3. So you are subtracting your 2, 6, 5 from 6 to 4, and your answer is this one. So homework, please do some homework. 511 minus 33. Let's see what's the value. And 6000 minus 777. Try to find out these two. Subtract. Hexadecimal subtraction. Again, let's logic is same, method is same, only your base is changed. In case of decimals, your base was 10. In case of binary, your base was 2. In case of octal, your base was 8. Now, in case of hexadecimal, your base is 16. And everything will be same, logic, all the logic will be same. We have to extrapolate this, our all the logic. Yet we learn from three number system. We have to extrapolate this logic from this three number system to another number system. This is the hexadecimal number system. Only difference in the base. Otherwise, the all are remain same. Take the two number 9, 6, 5, 4, and you are subtracting 5, 3, 2, 1. It is the base simple. It is. It is a 4, it is a 1, 3, it is 2, it is 5, 3, 3 and 6, 3, and it is 5, it is 9, 4. It is a very simple. Now take another example. 9, 7, 4, 3, and you have to subtract 5, 8. 7, 3. Okay, instead of 3, you can take a little bit different number. to take 9, 7, 4 D and 5, 8, 7, 5, 8, 7 to take this different. So in case of hexadecimal number, we have 0 to 9, then 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So it will be A, B, it is C, it is D, it is E, and it is your F. Now it is a C. C means your 12. D means 11. So you cannot subtract. You have to take a borrow one number from here. If you take the borrow, then it will be value will be this D will be 16 plus 11. 16 plus 11, it will be value will be 27. And if you subtract C, C means 12, so it remains 15. 15 means your value is F, so it is the F. Now giving a carry, its value is the 3. It is the 7. So you have to take one carry from here. Now 3 plus 16 will be, what will be, 19. You have to subtract 19 minus 7. 19 minus 7 will be 12. And 12 will be that 3. After giving a carry from this one to this one, now it is below the 6. Again, you have a problem, it is the 8, it is the 6. So you have to take another carry from here to here. One carry you have to take. So 6 plus 16, it will be 22. 22 minus 8, it will be. What will be 22 minus 8? It will be 14. Sorry, 14 means your E. So, after giving carry from here to here, you have a 8. So, 5 minus 8, it will be your. So this is the hexadecimal, your subtraction. You are subtracting 587C from 974B. In this way you can subtract in hexadecimal number. So at a homework you try to take two numbers in F. A, B, minus A, F, 1, and take another example, 7, 7, 8, 8, minus E, F. These two numbers, these two examples, you do at your homework. Now come to multiplication. So binary multiplication. It is same as the logic. We have to extrapolate the logic of multiplication from decimal to binary. In case of summation, what was the rule? 0 plus 0, your sum. One plus zero, one, zero, two plus one, zero, one, plus one, from zero, maybe one. And this is the summation. And in case of product, if you take product, then zero into zero equal to zero, zero into one, or one into zero equal to zero, one into one. Equal to 1. let's take the two multiplex. Let's take the one example. First example, 1010, you have to multiply with 101. Already I make it a table. You can see this is the voltage 2 to the power 5, 2 to the power 4, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 1, and it is 2 to the power 0. You can write 1010 in this way, 1010 and 101, 101. Now, here is, if you multiply here to here, 0 to 1 to 0, it will be 0, 1 to 1, it will be 1, 1 to 0, it will be 0, 1 to 1, it will be 1. Because here you have a power 2 to the power 0 and here your power 2 to the power 1. So total power will add. How the power will add, I will discuss in the next example. Here it will 2 to the power 0. So here it is 2 to the power 1. Here it will be, it will here 2 to the power 0. So 0 into 0, you cannot write 0 here. You have to write 0 here. Why? Because here it is the power 1, here it is the power 0. If you add the two power, it will be power will be 1. Power always it will the sum will be the sum. So you have to add the power. So here it is the 0 to the power 1. What is 1? Here it will be 0. So power will be 1. You cannot write here. Here it is the 1, it is the 1, so power will be power will be your 2. Here 1 and 2, it will be 3. Here 1 and 3, it will be 4. Now you can see this one. This is the power, power will be 2 and it is the 0. So this is the power 2 and this is the 0. So power will be 2. So we have to write from here 0, and if you have to give the 1, this is the power here power 3, so it will be go to the power 3 1, and it will be 1, and this is the 0, so power this 2 and here power 2, it will be go to the power here, but 0, and here 2 and 3, power will be 5, so here it will go to the 1. Now you have to add. If you add, this is the 0, 0, this is the 1, this is the 0, then this will be 1, 0, 1, it will be 0, and 1 1 0 and 1 carry, carry will be go left next power left hand side. So 1 0 0 to be 1 and 1.
Sir,
yes,
sir, it is a little bit convert 1010 into our normal decimal system and then convert 101 into our normal decimal system and then product that one, and then after getting the decimal product, can we convert that into binary product?
Yeah, it will binary be same number. It will be same. Now let's see what the value of 1010.
Yes sir.
1010, what is the value of 1010? It will be
2 plus 2 power 4 plus 2 power 5.
Okay, it will be 8 plus 2 means
2 plus 16 plus 32.
No, If you multiply it, what will be the?
Sir, I am telling answer, sir. Direct
okay.
answer.
Okay, 10 multiply by what is the value? 4 on 5. It will be 50.
Yes,
50. So, because it is 8 plus 2 is equal to 10, and here it will be 4 plus 1 is equal to 5.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so,
sir.
It will if you multiply this one, it will be 50. And what is the value? It is the 1, 2, means 2, then 4, 8, 16.
Yes, sir.
16 plus
32.
So what will be? It will be also 50.
50. Yes, sir.
You have to learn the binary multiplication. What you are telling, it is okay. But it is not a method of binary multiplication. You have to learn the how to binary multiplication. Because a machine never do this type of decimal multiplication. If you give your computer 10 into 5, you can easily calculate the 50. But your machine never calculate this 50. Your machine convert this 10 to this one, this 5 to this one, and then the machine will multiply in this way. And again, next result will your machine publish in this way, and you have to convert. This is your 50.
Okay, sir.
Your machine will not do. Your simplification we can do, and you have to know how the binary multiplication happened.
Yes, sir.
What you are telling it is true, and it is very easy. But your machine never do this this way. Your machine will do in this way.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Okay, and similarly in your home you try to do some this multiplication. So you take 1 0 1 0 and multiply 1 1. Let's see what happened. And also you do some another example. That's example 2, 1 1 0 1 and multiply by 1 1. Let's see what happens. You try to practice. So now we have to go the complement. R's complements and R minus 1's complement. So there is generally two types of complements, RF complements and R minus 1's complement. This is the RS complement and R minus 1's complement. In case of binary radix or your base is 2, so 2 is complement and 1's complement in binary. In decimals, it is the 10th complements and 9th complement. And similarly, it is another. For other number system, it will be others. Generally, nth complements we are write in this way. rth complement. Rth complement, we can write r to the power n minus. Where R is your radix or base, N is your number of digit, and this N is equal to your number. R is equal to base, N is equal to your number, and small n is equal to your number of digit. So Rth complement R to the power N minus N. So if you take example, N is equal to 5 6 9 0 10. You have to find out the Rth complement. Rth complement means 10th complement. Here is a decimal number and 10 is your base. So here your R is equal to 10. N is equal to 5 6 9 0 and small n equal to your 4. So arithmetic value will be 10 to the power 4 minus 5, 6, 9. Means 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 minus 5, 6, 9. This is your arithmetic complement. It is your 10th complement. In case of you take a binary number, n is equal to 1101 in case of 2. So r is equal to your 2, n is equal to your 4, and n is equal to 1101. So whose complement? Which complement will be 2 to the power 4 minus 1101. 2 to the power 4 means 100. It is the 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, 1 minus 1101. This is your which complement. Okay, let's so 1101. This is the number, and which complement 2 to the power 4 minus 1101. It will be 100000 minus 1101, and if you subtract, it will be 1101. This is your which complement. This is your which complement. So try to homework. N is equal to 7, 6, 8, 9, 5. Find out the 10th complement. This is your decimal number 10th complement, and you could take another 1101 and find out the which complement. R minus 1's complement. So we have a R equal to 10 R equal to 2, R equal to 8, R equal to 16. So it will be 10's complement, 2's complement, 8's complement, and 16's complement. And R minus 1's complement is 9. Nine's complement, 1's complement, it will be 7's complement and 15's complement. 15's complement, or sometimes it is called the F's complement. So R's complements, we know the R means R's complement is equal to R to the power n minus n. And R minus 1's Yes.
Sir, how does the computer know that 0011 is negative? How does it know that it is not 3?
Okay, we'll discuss. It is just we are entering the complement, then we'll go to the signed and unsigned number system. We have to give certain, we have to set certain parameter, certain method, so computer will understand. We have to go to the signed bit number system, and various way we can give this type of explanation. So just I am entering the complement, once or two complement, then we'll go to the your signed bit number system. We'll do, definitely. R minus 1's complement is equal to, you can see R minus 1's complement is equal to R's complement minus 1, means is equal to R to the power n minus 1. R minus 1's complement is equal to R's complement minus 1. So this is the R minus 1's complements minus 1, means R minus 1's complements equal to R's complements minus 1. R minus 1's complement is equal to R's complement minus 1. This is the methods R minus 1's complement. Okay, you can see the seventh complement. Seventh complement of 5 6 7 4. It is the seventh complement. So we have to do the eighth complement minus 1. Eight complements. What are the eight complements? 8 to the power 4 minus 5, 6, 7, 4. It is the eighth complement minus 1. It will be the seventh complement of this number. So it will be, if you subtract this one, you can get the seventh complement of this one. And now
sir, we have to do this subtraction using octal subtraction rule, no?
Yes, you have to do the octal subtraction rule. It is the which one?
This one, 7.
Seventh complement. Yes, you have to do the using octal octal rule.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you take another example.
Hello, sir.
One's complement. One's complement of.
Sir, what is the meaning of complement?
Huh?
What is the meaning of a complement?
Complements like one operation. Right now, you know the one operation. Like a subtraction one operation, you are doing complement. Complement doing one type of mathematical operation. What the already you know the two types complement. One R's complement. There is a method to find out the R's complement, and there is a method to find out the R minus 1's complement. And it is a very useful to subtract any methods or represent any method, any numbers in terms of its sign. If a positive, how to get the negative, negative, how to do the positive. It is a very efficient method using this complement. Later we'll discuss. First, you know the complement means one type of mathematical operation. If you take this one, find out the one complement of 1 0 0 1. This is the one. Find out the one's complement on this one. How to find do this one's complement? This one. First, we have to do the 2's complement. 2's complement here, we have a digit 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can write 2 to the power 4 minus 1, 1, 0, 1. 2 to the 4 means 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 1, 0, 1. If you minus, what will be the its value? Means it is 16, and it is very shortcut way. It is 8 plus 4, 12, 13. This is your 2's complement. This is the 2's complement. Then so 1's complement, it will be 0, 0, 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. So it will be 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. This is your 1's complement. And what is the previous number? 1. 1 0 1, and its 1's complement 0 0 1 0. If you have any number by a binary system, if you say just pass it to it through the NAND gate, it will give the complement. Means so it is your number, it is your 1's complement. So 1 to 0 1 1 to 0 0 to 1 1 to 1. So this is your number, this is your 1's complement. If you take another number, if you take 1 0 1 0, what will be the 1's complement? 0 1. This will be your 1's complement. So you are taking one number 1010. It's the binary number.
Your screen has been stopped sharing.
Again?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I have to time you.